We were talking about two-stage op-amp, and we learned that our ultimate goal is to improve gain with high bandwidth. So if you want to increase the gain, you need to add stages, or you can keep the system in cascade to achieve the gain. But as you are adding the stages, it will reduce the bandwidth. So that's bad part of this one, that it reduces the bandwidth. It will increase the gain. So one more thing is that bandwidth may be increased by increasing the tail current. So if you are keep on increasing the tail current, the bandwidth will increase, or you can say that the pole will going away and away from the origin, and it will be in a negative side. So if you are increasing the current, the first pole is going away from origin along with bandwidth is UGBW will also increase. If you are increasing the second stage current, then the second pole is going out. So increasing current will increase the pole location. That is also one fact. And tail current and load capacitance, both are actually going to give you advantage for having the better slew rate or better or sharp response at the output side. So these things we already studied, and if you want to improve the gain, you can make the cascode structure. So you can add more number of transistor on top of each other, and you will get the better gain. Gain is improved by GM times RO, because your output impedance is getting increased and increased. However, the structure limits swing or OCMR. If there are there is only 1 volt supply voltage, maybe you can take only 4 transistors in cascode, not more than that, or more only 4 transistors should be seen. But still it will be difficult, because 1 volt means each transistor needs 250 millivolt each. So across PVT this might not work, so you should not choose such a system, right? But if it is 1.2 volt or 1.8 volt, you can take 4 transistors, 5 transistors, right? There is no problem. So you have to choose the structure according to your requirement and according to the what value of voltage is available. So this structure is popularly known as telescopic cascode amplifier. We already talked about this one. One more thing, okay, before going to telescopic, I understand a small thing from the query from Sonali, that those who are not achieving phase margin, let's assume that this is the system, let's make this one. So there are two things are here. When you are designing, you are going to start from the tail current, right? So here I need current. Just look at two quantities. I need here current, or this is the reference current generator, which is going to be used as a tail current for the system. So I am going to find out what bandwidth is needed for that bandwidth, how much slew rate is needed, and for that slew rate how much current is required for a given load capacitance. For that, that current will be designed here. First of all, for any load, this current will not change, because that's the characteristic of this current mirror system, right? So once this is fixed, there is no problem. Next part is, some people are increasing this WL. First of all, and increasing this W by L. But what is going to happen if you are increasing capacitance, like increasing W by L, actually increasing cap, effective capacitance. If you are increasing the capacitance, what will be the problem in your opinion? What do you think? Pole is going inside. So pole is going towards origin, right? If your system is one stage, there is no problem, because where the pole is, it doesn't matter, it will change your bandwidth, that's it. But if your system is this one, where W by L of this system is very high or very high everywhere, then what is going to happen? Your UGBW is here, capacitor is lower, so there might be the case that this capacitor is inside or inside this blue pole, right? If it is lower value, then what you have to do, you have to increase current maybe to take it outside. This is one way, but it takes lots of current. Those who are designing for 1 microampere current only, right? So this is a specific problem for Purvesh and Sonali. They want to design for 1 micro, and their phase margin is coming minus 27 degree. Yeah, so what I can do, I can increase this current, but it will violate their budget. So what they have to do, they have to decrease these W by L. Maybe they can go to minimum one, or they can go to minimum one. All these are coming into the picture, and they are adding the capacitance, and we don't want to increase the capacitance. Let's design it for minimum and understand one thing, that as this was reference current, this is not reference current, this is reference voltage. We need voltages here, we don't need current. So in that case, you can design it efficiently if they are at minimum side. Then you have to keep this pole outside. And for looking at pole zero, you should not look at PZ analysis, because it's sometimes confusing, because there are lots of poles and zeros are given. Maybe there are 8 poles and let's assume the 7 zeros. But all poles and zeros are not useful for our analysis, because some of the poles are sitting on top of zeros. So it's a, one is 121 megahertz. This one is minus 120 megahertz. So they are sitting on top of each other. So that effective, effectively they are not, they are canceling each other, and there is no use. So in that case, it's better to look at the magnitude plot, because by looking at magnitude plot, you can say that how many poles and zeros are available. Just you have to look at the slope, right? You should use the cursors. You know how to use cursors. Are you using cursors? No. Okay, then you should use, let's say you have to use the hotkey A and B from your keyboard. You should press one time A, one time B. So when you are doing A, it will have X and Y coordinate. When you are pressing B, it will again make another coordinates, X and Y. And at the bottom, there are 2 things are written. One must be delta X, delta Y, and slope. So you can directly find out what is the slope available, right? Or otherwise you can measure it through your eyes, right? So is there any other hotkey for latest version? These are the one. Okay, so A and B you should use, and you can have two cursors. So one is this way, you will have your cursors. It will look like this one, right? So this is what you need to do, and you have to find out if there is zero is available here, you want to find out, you want to keep it outside, then you have to decrease W by L or increase W by L accordingly. You have to find out what is your requirement, right? So that was the thing. Maybe my TA will help you and fix it. If others need help, we can help you in this 1 week, right? This is last week, so let's complete this op-amp design. I believe Purvesh is near to complete his design. So others should expedite the process and should complete and should get 15 marks. Look, those who will design better way, maybe I'll give bonus marks also. If you can design better way, we'll see. Better way means if you are designing something which is ultra low power or implementing some paper. But if you don't want to do that, it's okay. Do the regular thing, you will be given 15 marks and you know what is the rule. Okay. Now, okay, so let's come to the point where I was. Is it here? No. Where is it? I studied this one. Okay, we all know about all these things, but okay, so let's talk about the case when there is a PMOS as an input. So sometimes like people have asked me which kind of amplifier we should use, amplifier with NMOS or with PMOS. So if this is Vin plus and this is Vin minus, do you have any advantage if you have PMOS as an input? What do you think? We haven't studied, but I'm asking you this question. If you know, then you can tell me. It's same, right? VDS, VDS. I can see three VDS. Right. Anything else? Saurabh, what do you think?
Low speed.
Why this is going to give you low speed? Speed is, when we are talking about speed, it's about frequency, and frequency is controlled by only one element, that's the current.
Output swing
is still 3 VDS set.
Size of NMOS,
you can make it with similar GM. What's the problem? So now input GM is dominated by these two pairs, output resistance is dominated by M3 M4, and the tail current, instead of tail current, you have some another current which is coming from top, right? So earlier we had current at tail, but now current is coming from top. So this is deciding the speed or bandwidth or slew rate. All are synonyms, right? So what do you think? There is only one chapter we have not studied. Because of lack of time, we could not study it. And that chapter name is, it's 7th number chapter, noise. So right now I cannot derive the formula, but when you are using the PMOS as an input, it will give you low noise. And NMOS has higher noise compared to PMOS, right? Because of the mobility. So mobility between PMOS and NMOS, mobility of PMOS is lower or higher? PMOS is lower. So that's why, because of this mobility, it's a low noise. So that is the advantage. If you are if somebody has given you a specification to design an amplifier with low noise, then you should use only with PMOS input. So this was one of the question asked by somebody. Sunari, you asked me. Okay. So this is when it's low noise, then you should use it. Otherwise, no. Right, So for all of you, you need to design it with NMOS. PMOS is not required, but if it is low noise application, you should do that. Right. You must have heard this low noise amplifier. I prefer to make it using PMOS. This also amplify the signal, but I'll keep it low noise by inherent property of PMOS. Right. Okay. Next thing is, I want to increase the gain. Still it's PMOS input. This will give me better noise profile. This is the current coming from top. This is deciding the speed, bandwidth or slew rate. Inputs of M1 and M2, W by L is deciding GM of the transistor, and this one is the output resistance. Output resistance, looking at Vout, is nothing but, so both are, let's call it RO4 times GM4 times RO4, right? So that's the output resistance, neglecting other resistances, right? From here also you can see there is one more cascode figure is seen, right? So I neglected that. In this case, when we are designing, the only thing is there are four transistors in actually looking into actually one top of another one. So there are four voltage sources are there like this.
Sir, how are we biasing the lower
Yeah, till now we have I'm going to talk about it. So here there are four transistors. All are going to give you VDS5, VDS2, VDS4 and VDS4, right? So we know that 250 millivolt is the minimum. You can go beyond 250 millivolt. So if this is 1 volt, this is not going to work. You have to have at least 1.1 volt, 1.2 volt or something, which is which can make sure that all these transistors will be in saturation with 250 millivolt across all the transistor. To make these transistors in saturation or having 250 millivolt, what we can do, this is already connected as a diode connection load. So if this is diode connected, there is no problem, this is always in saturation. For another transistor which is at bottom, this needs the biasing voltage which is coming from here. Remember here, when you are designing this, are you following till now? Okay, so when you are designing, we know that W by L should not be increasing randomly. If it is increased, the effective capacitance looking into this node is higher, so your bandwidth is lower. Or if this is the case for the second stage, then the problem is this capacitance is also lower and it's coming into the bandwidth or UGBW. So phase margin will be very bad. So we have to understand one fact that this VB1 is a voltage reference and this VB2 is deciding the current flowing through this one. So there are two quantities, one is current and one is voltage. Here I want current, so much current will decide speed, bandwidth and slew rate. Here voltage decides the required voltage across VDS. Right. So you should not touch W of M3 and M4, but you should touch W by L of this transistor, which is going to change the voltage required here. So this voltage reference generator, if it is voltage reference generator, you have to tune it through a diode which is coming from outside. You should not tune it from the inside loop. But you are interested in better R out, then you can increase this W. Sorry, increase this length 2 times, 3 times, whichever you like. If you are doing so, then it's a ratio which you have to maintain. Sometimes it will work with the minimum W and 3 times L. So generally when I'm designing, I keep 3 times L because I'm interested in better RO4, and I'm not going to touch W by L of this one, because anyhow this is going to give me GM times RO. It's a big number, so it's not a problem. RO4 has to be 1 to 10 kilo ohm. So I'm trying for better resistance, so I'm increasing L by 3 times. Similarly here I'm increasing 3 times L just to make sure that there is no channel length modulation. If you remember, we are doing this for this L by delta L, this lateral diffusion length, and when we are doing so, we are just touching the multiplier. By touching the multiplier, you can have the different value of current. By touching the voltage here, you are changing the VDS here. That is the only thing we are doing. So you should not touch randomly other things, right? Do you agree with this one? Right. So when you are doing this, your capacitance will be minimum with the highest speed. Otherwise, capacitance is increasing even though current is very high. You will not get required bandwidth. So this is the way to design a cascode amplifier. There might be many different topologies where you can design it very, very easily. The easier way is this one. You can connect like this. So this point and this point are shorted, and at here I'm connecting the bias voltage which is coming from another side. This is the easiest way to design any cascode amplifier, where it will be very easy. One of the transistor will go out of saturation, but like this one, M3, or M3 will have the minimum VDS, but still it will work. It needs the minimum effort. That's why we are doing this. This is called self bias current technique, which we have studied in current mirror. So you can use any current mirror technique if you want. Still it will work. It requires different W by L's, a combination, right?
Sir, why do we connect this to a capacitor?
This is also actually diode connected. It's same as the previous one. The only thing is this voltage is coming here. So this higher voltage is coming here. Look at this. Here it will be 2 VDS set. Or VGS is coming here.
And the see,
upper one you need more than 2 VDS set. Right? Which is going to be designed from outside, and it's a voltage reference generator. It's not current reference generator. You need voltage, so much voltage. That can be found out by common mode range required at the gate of the transistor, right? Some people may use triple cascode if you have 5 volt or 6 volt. The old technology, we used to have higher voltages, so we used to add more and more cascode, and we used to get a better gain, right? So Purvesh, you connected 2 only, right? With the 1.2 volt. And you are achieving 75 dB gain with the 2 stage. Okay. So if you want to have the better gain, you can connect it here if you have higher available voltage. Otherwise, this is not required. Is there anybody else who has designed op-amp or have worked on it? Yeah, Ankit. There is no problem, bro. Do not worry. So, Piyush.
Sir, I didn't do same, but there's problem with
stability. Stability is the problem. So the only reason is you have increased W by L, which is in the path.
I have to increase current because bandwidth was 1 meter.
So, oh.
to increase current IFT to decrease it. So I think then the WIS values might be.
Yes. So if you need any help, like Vijender, Indu, Suhail, and Dinesh is also here, so all will help you if you want. So you can choose one of the TA who can help you, right? And same for you, it's for all, but they will not design for you. You have to design first, and then if you need if you have any query, then they can help you. Right? So do not design for them, please help them. Okay. So they know how to help. Okay, so if they have designed it, they can like help you. Anyway, so this cascode structure, if it is telescopic, you can have better gain. There is no problem. The negative point is swing. So if you want to have the better swing, what you can do, you can add one more stage where you have better swing, like this. Right. Or if you are interested in getting a voltage as the output, you can make common drain, right? Then this is voltage, output side is also voltage, so it's not OTA, it's op-amp. Otherwise whatever you are designing is an OTA. Anyway, one more thing is says that if you are having so many cascoded transistors, you will have better gain, but the only problem is swing. So if you want to avoid the problem of swing, there is another topology which is not telescopic. So what we have studied right now, it's telescopic. Other than telescopic, there is something called folded cascode. So what simple folded cascode says, input is again PMOS, you can make it NMOS also, there is no problem. So Vin with input transistor, RD is the load, and I'm keeping one transistor having some bias. If I'm looking upside, it's GM1 times Vin, that's the current. And if I connect here, simple current I1, then controlled voltage is not actually common mode, but the controlling point is I1. I1 will tell that how much current is flowing through this node and this node. Right. Earlier it was depending only on Vin. Right now it's not depending on Vin. The role of Vin is to just make sure that this M1 is in saturation, or VDS will be some VDS set, or more than 250 millivolt. This is decided by Vin, which is DC plus AC. This is going to tell you that how much current is flowing through this particular system, or how much will be divided in two branches. It will again follow the KCL. We'll look at the design strategy after this. So this is the strategy which we are going to use, where you can make the cascode amplifier even with NMOS side. So earlier it was PMOS, right now it's NMOS. So what do you think, what will be the advantage, which one will be the advantageous topology, with PMOS or NMOS? And what is the advantage part in PMOS?
Low noise.
Low noise. But if you are not interested in low noise, it doesn't matter. Sometimes you are not interested in low noise at all, right? You want to amplify it, that's it. This is the specific application of RF or some biomedical applications where you need low noise. Otherwise it's not needed every time. So this is one of the popular way, because everybody likes to keep it with NMOS, so I kept it NMOS. NMOS having input transistor, which is going to give you GM. The current flowing through this one is deciding the speed, bandwidth, slew rate, depending on the available load cap. and these two transistors are acting as output, where you may have some cascode connection. We can look at that, how this cascode is playing the role. But so we may have one budget design question where you have to budget the thing. Budget the, so look at this, it's just making the budget. Budget the required specification for the op amp whose gain is 80 dB with the bandwidth of 1 gigahertz. So this number is very big, this number is very big for a standard 90 nanometer CMOS technology. The required specifications are as follows. So you have to find out and you have to tell me. So how many number of stages are required?
Three
stages. Okay, how did you find out it?
Two will not get more than 60.
Okay, so Gaurav is saying that 60 dB possible with two stage op amp with, right? But what Purves is saying, is it possible, right? So two stages 80 dB with telescopic, it's possible.
Bandwidth.
Yeah, bandwidth, we will pump more current. Right? So there is no other alternate. Look, telescopic is the one which is going to give you better bandwidth. Cascode is the one which is going to give you better bandwidth. Three stages will have higher power consumption compared to two stages of telescopic. You agree with this one?
So, but if we are increasing current, also the power dissipation will increase.
Yes, of course. So here in three stages I need more power than two stages. This is the first thing. You agree with this one or not?
I'm not.
Okay, so let's start from here. So if I want higher bandwidth, I need more number of stages. If I need higher bandwidth, I need more current from each of the stages, because each stage is going to give me one pole at least. So first pole, this is UGBW, second pole, third pole, there might be zero, there might be input pole which is here. So FP1, FP2, FP3, and this is some zero, and this is input because of 50 ohm, it's very available at very high frequency, right? So to keep FP2 higher than FP1, if FP1 needs 1 milliampere of current as a tail current, then FP2 needs at least 2 to 3 milliampere to keep it away from the first pole. Yeah, UGBW or the first pole. This needs even higher than this one, 5 to 6 milliampere, right? So others are not needed, so this is not require any current. It will burn the area because I am going to use a big Miller compensation, Miller compensating capacitor, right? So this is more current. But in the case when it's, if I am making the cascode, FP1 is here, FP2 is here, because it's only two stages, so there are effectively two poles, right? That is what you have experienced, right? Effective two poles. There might be one zero end pole which are coming. Okay, one word I am going to teach you. So by chance, poles and zeros are very much nearby, they can cancel each other, they are very much nearby, but still they are not canceling. And if you want to take this one in your analysis, then this kind of pole zero is known as pole zero doublet. Unfortunately, because of less amount of time, I am not touching this topic, so I removed it for this year. But such kind of thing is going to happen, and it's called pole zero doublet. In cascode, there are few pole zero doublets are coming, and we are not considering them. We consider them, they are sitting on top of each other. But there are some pole zero doublets, right? You must have seen. And so if you want to achieve less current, then you should use two stages for a given bandwidth. If instead of 1 gigahertz, if it is written 1 megahertz, you can use three stages. If it is written 100 kilohertz, you can use three stages, no problem. it is not burning much power, because still you are in microwatt or microampere of current. But if you need to have lower power, it's not a good thing, right? So 1 milli is a truly very high current for VLSI technology. So maybe I can ask you, so what to do if there is a chip which is consuming more power? Then do I have any technique to reduce the power? So there is something called heat sink. You should keep here heat sink. Do you know? You heard about heat sink?
Yes.
So there is something, aluminium metal is sticking to the chip, which is going to take all the power or the energy, thermal energy created by our chip. This will be consumed by our metallic, preferably aluminium heat sink. If this doesn't work, then people keep it here fan on top of this one. So there is no other method. If you can find out, you can become easily billionaire. If you can find out any other technique than heat sink and fan, you know, in power electronics, or you know, the, if it is power MOSFETs, they are consuming lots of power, and still we don't have any other good technique than this heat sink and fan. So try to find out. Who knows? You can find out some easy way.
Than this.
You can think about it. I don't know. You have to explain me how you are going to use this liquid. So what are you planning? I don't know. You should use some technique which is not available right now in the market. So the best working techniques are these two. You may say that you should use your mobile only in your fridge. That will not work. Right?
So there is something called Peltier module.
Peltier. Peltier effect is the one which is actually it follows the thermodynamic second law.
Yeah.
Right. So
one part of it is really cold and other side is hot.
Yeah. So one is acting as a reference. One is cold and one is hot. Right. And through this one, there is a Peltier effect, and it's creating the voltage. That's the Peltier effect. So through this one, you can harvest this energy for the voltage. That is what people are doing actually. But they are not able to reduce this power consumption. Right? What you are saying, it's known as energy harvesting system. So you can harvest it, but you cannot reduce it. That's the problem.
Right. I thought that we can put the cold part on the top of the chip.
Cold part, okay. Still it's similar to fan only, right? You are giving some low energy. Instead of this one, you can make even air condition also. Small air condition if you can design using MEMS. You know MEMS? It's called micro electro mechanical system. So small, some small things are created in the chip design, and which are going to be used in mobile technology. Some people are making small thermistors, small robots, small guitars, small many things, right? So here, number of stages will be 2. If you are so much interested in power dissipation. So the total power dissipation can be found out by the required bandwidth. Yes, because I know that I need bandwidth of 1 gigahertz, right? And I need the UGBW of gain times bandwidth. So 80 dB times 1 giga, that is going to give me gain bandwidth, UGBW. From UGBW, I can find out slew rate for the load of 1 picofarad. If I can find out that load, I can find out how much current required from each stage, right? If I can find out that, I can find out the maximum power dissipation also. Now, if I am using 2 stages, I can write down the phase equation. right? I can write down this for phase margin. I can write down 180 degree, that's phase margin. I need the phase margin of 60 degree. I need to make a budget that omega p2 is beyond UGBW. All omega is equal to GBW. 0 is 10 times higher than omega p2. Omega p2 is 2 times higher than omega. I can keep these budget and I can find out how much well, and omega p1 is nothing but 1 gigahertz, which I need. So from that I can find out the Miller compensated capacitor, because poles and zeros have some equations are given already. For Miller compensation, it's GM by CGD, that's the zero. For the budgeted value of 10 times omega p2 is equal to 10 times 2 times omega, right? That will give me value of CGD or the Miller compensation. Now I'm asking propose an output stage for a maximum swing. So you can use single stage, single ended, common source amplifier. That will give you maximum speed where you have only two transistors. If you have more transistors, then swing is minimum, it's not maximum. Draw the complete amplifier design. So complete amplifier design, we have drew somewhere. Okay, so you need right something like this. So this was just making the budget. After having the budget, you can design it for a given W by L, right? So any difficulty in this one? Actually you will learn more when you are going to design it. If you are not started, please start it. What is the deadline, Suhail? 17th. So 17th is the deadline for showing the results. So we are going to look at your terminal, what performance your transistors are giving, right? That is what we are going to look at your terminal. There is no report is on same day or
19th.
Okay, so on 17th we are not expecting the report. On 19th we are expecting the report.
Sir, what about the presentation?
Do you like presentation or do you want to keep it on? Okay, so they don't like presentation. Okay, if you want presentation, I don't have any problem. Okay. And meanwhile, if you are finding any difficulty, you can call me anytime. I'm only teaching your course and one course on Tuesday 2 to 5, and so other than that, these timings you can call me, no problem. Okay, if you feel that you stuck somewhere and you are not able to design, okay, or you can write me mail or you can call my TS. So they will help you for sure. It's a direct 15 marks, so please do not get 0 marks or lesser than 10 marks. Okay, it's easy, it's not so much difficult, you can do it, right? Okay, now there is one more thing. That thing says that if you are designing such a circuit in laboratory, have you tried this one in laboratory? No. Okay, Nadeem has not designed it. Okay, so Gaurav has designed it. This circuit, have you designed ever in microelectronics course? Is it microelectronics? Okay, so Nadeem, you have designed it. Okay, ye kiya hai na? Okay, that is the one. So it was a multi-stage. That was the only thing that like I was copied this circuit to achieve higher gain. I was adding the stages. So did you find any difficulty while designing this one in the laboratory? Share your experiences when you are designing in the laboratory. So have you used AC or DC coupling? Which coupling you have used? People are doing it in AC and that's the wrong thing. That's the most like most of the people are making this error. So you should do it in DC. So what you have seen, I believe, have you seen something like this? Nadeem, Ankit, Rakshit, Piyush and Piyush. Have you seen something like this? And it was not giving the full sine wave. Why it was not giving full sine wave? Yes, Shubham. And Shubham. Yeah. Are you following this, right? You must have done this one and you must have got such an output, which is not the expected one. Yes, so both are correct thing. So it's crossing the limit of supply. And Gaurav is saying some offset voltage. Your input is here. You're giving input here, but it gets amplified. Okay, it's actually wrong. I should have drawn, because it's acting as an inverter. So this input common mode, let's not call this one as offset, but output common mode. It's a DC quantity. This input common mode is designed by this one, right? And by the appropriate value of R1 and R2, you can find out what value of DC voltage is needed here, V in CN. And on top of this one, this small V in is going to write, and accordingly you will have the output. And you have to make sure that your signal has to be small signal. And I don't want so much of fluctuation between V in CM and V out CM. Still we are doing it, right? So let's assume that I fixed it and I got a good sine wave, no problem. So now I want higher gain than what I'm getting from the first stage. So the easiest way without using Cascode is to add the stage. So I have added one more stage. Do you see any problem here if I do this one?
Can again get
again that offset or the common mode is going to bother you, right? So this V in CM and this V out CM, between these two, V out CM was higher. So V out CM was higher than V in CM, and that V in CM is acting here as an input. Even though I'm connecting this R1 and R2, but it's going to be whichever will be the bigger one, that is going to be acted here, right? So I don't need this one. So what I can do? Are you following this? There is a problem, because those who cannot see this problem, let's look at this graphically.
So we can put a capacitor.
So this is V in CM, this is V out CM, and this is VCC. So this V out CM is here, and V out 2CM is even above than this one, right? So if it's not getting saturated in first stage, it will be saturated in second stage. So what Gaurav is suggesting, we can have a big capacitor like this one, which is going to block this DC. This DC is not going to talk to this DC, and both are independent. Whichever is available here, let it be there, and let's design it for Vout to CM. And that's why we are keeping another capacitor. So we should make sure that between all the stages we should have the capacitor, which we are going to call it coupling capacitor. So you can see each stage has actually one coupling capacitor. Even at the output, I am going to use it one more coupling capacitor. If I don't want to use this capacitor, I am going to use the AC coupling. It will solve the same thing, right? So you should not use DC. You can use it AC, and the DC will be available at zero. But just an illusion, in my opinion. Everybody should look at DC so that they can observe the available common mode voltage at each stage. Then and then they can design it efficiently, right? Yeah, so there is no problem. So the most important problem in multi-stage is common mode. So common mode is moving here and there. We have to design resistive network to create the required voltage, but resistances are taking more area and we don't prefer it in MOSFET or inside IC design. So we make another design which is actually in feedback, and we are going to call that design as common mode feedback, and in short form we are going to call it CMFB. In most of the design which I have given to you, you don't need common mode feedback. Some people need that, but we are not going to design it. You can design it for in higher course, or you should know that you need it or you don't need it. If you need it, then you need another amplifier having similar specification, and that has to be part of your operational amplifier. We are going to study those common mode feedback circuitry in next lecture. But the main thing is, you should understand that if you have more number of stages, not only one stage, then there is a problem of common mode. That's the most important problem, and we should actually address that. Yeah, Nadeem, you following? Right, so this is a problem you must have seen, and accordingly you must have tuned the value of R1 and R2. The gain was easily achieved, but the only problem is you are seeing some saturation. To stop that saturation, you have tuned R1 and R2. So we are not looking into this capacitor right now. Have you used this one? Okay, so what is the role of these capacitors? If you have used it, then
bypass array.
So as Subham is saying, it's a bypass capacitor. And what's the role of bypass capacitor? Not just reducing the gain, but it creates a zero. So the first stage, if it was look like this one, but after creating this capacitor, looks like this one. So at low frequency, you don't have much gain. If you want to remove the low frequency noise, then you can use this bypass capacitor, right? So each stage is creating one zero. If you don't want, if you want to see better gain, do not connect it, and you can see the higher gain, right? And that is created at 1 by Re times C radian per second. That is the value of that one. So accordingly, you have to design Re and CE value, right? So we'll talk about multi-stage amplifier with the common mode feedback circuitry tomorrow. Okay. Thank you.